The book Brilliant Blunders is about five giant scientists, and for each one of them, I chose one major blunder that they have made in the science that they have done. And all the blunders are connected through the thread of evolution. This is evolution of life, evolution of the Earth, evolution of stars, and evolution of the universe as a whole. But each one of them made some major blunder. Charles Darwin really needs no introduction. I mean, this is the naturalist that came up with the theory of evolution by natural selection. Some people say the greatest theory to have ever, you know, been written. It turns out that even such a luminary like Darwin made some huge blunder in some of his thinking. Charles Darwin didn't know genetics, and that's not surprising because nobody knew really genetics at his time. Basically, he thought that the way genetics works is that you mix the qualities of the father and the mother a bit like mixing paints, rather than like, say, mixing two decks of cards. His big blunder was that he didn't realize that with that kind of theory of genetics, natural selection would never have worked. Fred Hoyle was a famous astrophysicist and cosmologist. For about 25 years in the middle of the 20th century, he was probably the most prominent cosmologist around. So basically, he told us how stars evolve and how all the elements we're made of are made in stars and all that. But he also came up with an idea that our universe is never changing. It has always been the same and will always be the same, an idea which turned out to be completely wrong. Albert Einstein is the embodiment of genius for most people. He actually did a very interesting mistake. When he wanted to apply his theory of general relativity to the universe at large, he first introduced a certain term in order to keep the universe from collapsing under its own weight. Now, by doing that, he actually missed the opportunity to predict that the universe would be expanding. Then he took that term out, and by doing that, he missed the opportunity to tell, like we know today, that the universe would be accelerating. The way that we march to the truth is not on a straight line, but rather in this zigzag path, you know, finding one blunder after the other, and finding by that, those guide us to the correct way and the correct scientific theory.